About the new Microsoft Paint after Windows 11, we have prepared a detailed step-by-step tutorial for you about opening, saving, exporting and importing images in Microsoft Paint. This is the third in a series of comprehensive and detailed tutorials for beginners and those who want to learn about the new Microsoft Paint post Windows 11. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. As soon as we open the program, we are greeted by a workspace with a white canvas in the middle and a new Microsoft Paint that blends classic and modern style. The canvas is the image space inside the workspace. You can think of it like a real-life canvas. This is where the image is created and organized. We write and scribble something on the canvas and add the text, picture 1, to make it stand out. In a moment, we will save this work as an image file. If we select the Save command directly from the File menu, the changes we have made will be saved permanently. The word permanent is relatively permanent. There is another intention here. We will explain the details and the differences in implementation in a moment. When we run the direct save command from the file menu, the save menu opens immediately. From this save menu, we specify the type of image file, its name and the directory as location. After setting the file name as untitled, the type as PNG and the directory or location as desktop, we confirm the save command. After confirming the save command, the saved version of our image file was automatically transferred immediately to the desktop. Now we will make a few changes to show the difference of the direct save command. We will draw a few nested circle shapes in this already open image study and then we will run the direct save command again. Notice that when we run the save command directly, we reorganize the previous version that we had previously saved on the desktop with the same name and type and replace it with this latest modified version. At this point, the previous image file that we exported without drawing the circles is permanently deleted and replaced with the latest available version that we saved directly with the save command. Now we are going to make one more change to this already open project. We will undo one of the circles we have drawn with the undo command. And again we will run the save command directly and save it in the same file type, name and file directory. Similarly, we go through our currently open image projects one by one and undo them with the undo command until there are no circles left, save them and observe their final state on the desktop. You will notice that if we use the direct save command with the same name, same directory and type, each time the previous image file we exported will be permanently deleted and replaced with the latest available version that we saved with the direct save command. This time we save another version of the same type but with a different name, new image 1. In the desktop directory with a different save command without changing the existing file. This command is called save as. Now, while the previous version was on the desktop with the same name, another version with a different name was registered and transferred to the desktop. The first version was called untitled and saved as PNG. The new version was called New Image 1 and saved as PNG. And both files are in the same directory on the desktop. If we want to start and work on a new project instead of an existing or old project, we can choose to start a new project. When we want to start a new project, if there is a project we are working on and we have made changes to it but we have not made the last record, it gives a warning message. The warning message offers three different ways to choose whether to save the current project, close it without saving, or cancel the new project start. With cancel, you can cancel starting a new project. Starting a new project means exiting an existing project, which means you can only open one project at a time. You can start a new project while you have an existing project, but if you exit without saving, the project or any changes made will be completely lost, never to be accessed again. With cancel, we have the option to cancel the launch of a new project and undo our last defamation. After that, we start a new project and select the save option. We now have two previous works on the desktop with the last modified version saved and a new clean work already open waiting for us in the program. Each new project is started as usual, untitled, starting with a clean white background that we can later change in any way. For a better understanding of what we have learned up to this point, we write something with a calligraphy pen on the newly opened work and save this work on top of our previous untitled work with the direct save command, completely replacing the previous work. Here, at the full save confirmation stage, the program indicates that there is an existing file with this name and format in the same directory, and that if we save it, the previous one will be deleted and this latest project will be saved instead. We confirm and you can see that one of our previous files from the last changes we made on the desktop is now a new image completely changed. Here we have saved over it and completely replaced the previous version. We must therefore use the direct save command with extreme caution, because it is always risky to use the direct save command carelessly and recklessly. We will now examine the open command in the file menu, which allows us to open and edit an existing image file as a paint project. We open the picture of the bird called Red Parrot on the table. To remove the background of this bird image, we use the new AI-powered remove background command. We save this red parrot image with the background removed directly with the save command. Notice that the original version on the desktop has also been modified with the background removed. At this stage, with the current project open, we can undo the operation with the undo command and fix it directly with the save command. But if we save and close the work, this final version will permanently become the last save. Now, when we reopen the file, the undo commands are no longer available because they are stored in temporary memory. We have a permanent end state and we can no longer undo the background even if we wanted to. By the way, let's make another very important distinction. When the file format is JPEG, it does not support transparency and automatically fills it with a white background. If it were in PNG format, it would support transparency, and we will explain this in more detail in the following examples. And now we come to the most important point that we have been trying to explain all along. As we have already mentioned, we must use the direct save command with extreme caution, because it is always risky to use the direct save command carelessly and imprudently. With all these risks in mind, it is vital that you keep the originals of your important files and images as backups in a different directory. If you make irreversible saving errors or encounter other problems, a solution may be possible if you take precautions in advance. You can save a backup copy of the original file elsewhere and continue safely. We took a backup of the red parrot image on the desktop and replaced it with the old corrupted version and overwrote it. We also renamed it and edited it with the name V1 version 1. At this stage, we open the V1 backup red parrot image in JPEG format on the desktop in Paint. In the same way, we have removed the background with the AI background removal command. But this time we will save it differently. More precisely, the file directory will still be desktop and even in JPEG format, but we will change its name with the suffix v2 so that it does not save over it, and we will see that the first version is intact. Yes, we saved another version on the desktop, but if you notice, as we mentioned before, when the file format is JPEG, it doesn't support transparency and automatically fills it with a white background. If it was in PNG format, it would support transparency, and we will explain this in more detail in the next examples. Here we will save three versions of the recording in the same directory, that is the desktop, with the additional file name, V3, but in PNG, a format that supports transparency, and analyze the difference. As you can see, the differences between the previous recordings and the latest ones are clearer, and the V3 parrot image with background removed is transparent as it was created in PNG format. We close and reopen the Paint program. In normal settings, a standard Paint file with a white background without a title opens automatically. Drag and drop the V3 parrot image with the transparent background we created last time. As soon as you drop the parrot image, the project is ready to be edited in the Paint program with transparent properties and file name. The first opened or already open one is closed, and the image file dropped into it is opened from scratch with drag and drop. Likewise, when we open another image with drag and drop, the last image we opened with drag and drop is automatically opened and the current image or project is closed. We demonstrate this again and again with quick and different examples. In fact, in addition to drag and drop, we can also use the open command by selecting the file directory and file from the menu that opens with the open command in the file menu. This time we will do a different process, import to Canvas. That is, without closing the current project, we will create a new layer and add another image to that layer, and we will be able to work and edit multiple images at the same time in a single project. We imported a light blue gradient background image from a file on the desktop, one of our previous works. The size of the image we imported automatically expanded the canvas, and since the parrot image was on the top layer, it covered it. We move the new background image from the top layer to the bottom, behind the parrot image and back to the top again and saw the difference more clearly. We tried to resize the blue background gradient image to fit the parrot. By changing the position and placement of the images and then cropping them, we created another version of the parrot image with a new background. With a different save as representing version 4. We save it to the desktop in PNG format in a version with the additional name, V4, and examine all the image works we have created so far. As an example of how we can save different files with the same name in different file formats in the same directory, that is, on the desktop, we save and examine PNG and JPEG files with the additional name V4. We add a yellow star to the JPEG image so that it is not difficult to recognize at first glance. Another version with the same name is ready on the desktop in PNG format, and we examine them all again. As you can see, if any of the file or directory or name parameters are different, we can save the same file separately without saving it on top of another and without corrupting them. In this example, the file directory is the same, so they are both saved on the desktop. Even the image file names are the same, but the types are different. One is PNG and the other JPEG, so they can be side by side without overwriting and without corrupting the other. In fact, we observe two separate independent files with the same name and location but different types. However, as a suggestion, if it is not necessary, it would be wiser, instead of having the same file name, to distinguish them with an additional name difference, such as V5, so that their use in management becomes more practical. In this tutorial, we have provided a detailed step-by-step overview of opening, saving, exporting, and importing images in the new version of Paint. In future tutorials, we will cover the new features of Paint in more detail and even try to explain in full detail the use and application of all the tools. Of course, we'll learn how to do more complex things with layers using revolutionary new features, the advantages of background removal, and even dive deeper into creating AI-powered images. Let's keep exploring the new version of Paint together and unleash our creativity. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.